Hey guys, Nicole here with another Estes Education how-to video. Today, I'll be showing you how to build the Wizard Rocket. This is an intermediate level rocket and gives builders great experience with balsa wood fins. It only weighs half an ounce and has a very sleek design profile to minimize drag and get your rocket soaring high. The Wizard can be flown on a wide range of engines from a half A all the way up to a C. And on a C67, it'll go up to 1800 feet high. This is great for when you're doing studies on altitude, drag, or descent rates, and you need a longer flight time. The Wizard requires some sanding, some glue, and you can paint it in whatever color scheme you like, or decide to fly without painting it if you don't have the time. Let's build it. For this build, you are going to need your Wizard kit, a ruler, clear tape, sandpaper, plastic cement, hobby knife, pencil, masking tape, wood glue, and scissors. For the first step, we are going to assemble the nose cone. So you just need these two small pieces and then your plastic cement. You're gonna put plastic cement on the inside of here and then just put that piece in. And we use plastic cement here because we're doing two plastic pieces, so that gets them to adhere better. So put that in and then just let dry. Now we're going to prepare the fins. So first thing is you can just sand them on here so they're all flat together. Mine are kind of already coming off, so I'm just gonna sand them individually. But when you are popping them out of this balsa wood, you can use a hobby knife if you want. You just wanna be really careful. You wanna make sure you're not breaking any of these fins as you pop them out. So now we're going to sand them. So I'm gonna do mine individually first. Next up, we want to sand the edges, so you can put them together and do that all at once so they're nice and even. Next up, you can round the leading edges. So if you look at your instructions, it points out which of those two are. So just these two sides, we can round in this direction. Now your edges are rounded and your fins are prepped. All right, now we are going to mark the body tube so that we know where to attach the fins and the launch lug. So first is you're gonna need to cut out this tube marking guide from your instructions. Now we're gonna tape this around the bottom of the body tube. When you tape that, you want to make sure that it's really lined up evenly so that you're making your marks evenly. Then you can see these lines are labeled FL and LL. This is for fin line and then launch lug. So make sure you make some marks on both ends of the guide for each line. Then once those are marked, you can remove that guide. And then you need to use a straight edge to extend these lines. So you can use a door frame, or I'm gonna use this tube marking guide. And again, we're just extending these marks to make longer lines. So now I have your lines. I like to make mine dotted for the launch lug so I know that that one is different. But now your body tube is marked and ready to go. Next up, we are going to attach the fins, and we have a couple more marks we need to make on the body tube here. So we're gonna make a line on each of these fin lines at 3/8 of an inch up from the end, and that's where the bottom of our fin is gonna be. And then on our launch lug line, we're gonna make a line 2 inches from the end of the body tube. All right, now that those marks are done, we can attach our fins. So for gluing on balsa wood fins, first thing is you always want to make sure you know which direction you're putting it. So hopefully just look at your instructions. Again, you have your rounded edges, so those ones should be facing out. So kind of plan out where you're going to put it. And then to make them stick better, if it works well if you add one layer of glue and let it dry for a minute, makes it really sticky and tacky, then add another layer and put it on. So that's what we're going to do next. So once our first layer has dried, we'll go ahead and apply our second layer and then put it on the body tube. So make sure that the bottom of your fin is at that mark at 3/8 of an inch that you put, and then try to make it as straight as you can. We will align it in just a second. And then repeat for the other two fins. As with other things we've glued, use less glue than you think you need. More glue is just going to make them kind of slide around and be difficult to arrange. So once you have three on there, get your instructions and you can see this shaded fin alignment guide. So you want to look from the top and make sure that your fins are aligned and perpendicular. Then you can go ahead and let those dry. Once your fins have dried, if you want to, you can add fillets on each of them just to increase stability and strength of that attachment. So to do that, you'll add just a thin line of glue on this seam, and then I like to just use my finger to push it into that seam, and we'll do that all the way around. Then again, we'll just let that dry. Next up, we're going to install the engine block. So first take your yellow spacer tool and we're gonna put a mark on this at 1/4 of an inch. Okay, then we're going to be putting the engine block in the body tube here and we want it to be 2 inches up. So I'm gonna be applying glue to the inside of the body tube with just this scrap piece of balsa wood, but I'm gonna make a mark on this at 2 inches so I know how far to put it. Then you can just apply glue to this and put it inside the body tube. Then once you have enough glue in there, you'll put your green little engine block in there. And then you're gonna use the spacer tool to push it up and you'll go until you hit that mark that you made. So go ahead and push it till there and then take your spacer tool out and let that dry. Next up, we're going to attach the launch lug to the body tube. This is how the rocket goes onto the launch rod. So it's really important that when we attach this, it's parallel to the body tube. So you don't want it to be at an angle. That's why we made this straight line earlier. And then you have your mark here at 2 inches. So that should be where the bottom of the launch lug sits. Then you can just apply glue to this and put it on. Then let it dry. All right, now we are going to install the shock cord. So first you'll need the shock cord mount from the front page of your instructions. You can go ahead and cut that out. Now you're going to take just one end of the shock cord, lay it on here on the number 2, and you'll just put a bit of glue there and then fold the 1 over. Okay, let that set for a second and then you'll do the same thing. Put some glue here and fold it over. And make sure that you don't use too much glue here. You don't want it to soak through the paper, so you really don't need too much. Then you can just hold that for a second to make it set. Once that is set, then we're going to install this into the body tube. So we're just gonna put some glue on here and put it in the body tube. You want it to be at least an inch and a half down because you don't want it to get in the way of the nose cone when you're putting that on. So I like to really just put it about as far in as I can reach. So we'll put some glue here and put that in. And then you can hold that and let it dry. Next up, we are gonna prepare our flight recovery. So first thing is we need to attach this shock cord to the nose cone that we put together earlier. So you're just gonna do a double knot here. Okay, now we need to attach our streamer. So you're gonna get a piece of clear tape and tape this on, or you can tie it with a double knot onto the shock cord if you want. And really, this is a pretty short shock cord, so anywhere in between, instructions say about 2 inches down from the nose cone. All right, so now that's taped on. So now if you're going to be launching your rocket soon, we can add some recovery wadding. If not, you can just fold the streamer and tuck that inside. But to show you what to do with the recovery wadding, we are gonna take 2 individual squares and crumple them up a little bit and put them in the body tube. You don't want to crumple them too small, but this is a pretty small body tube, so small enough to get in there. And we'll do 2 squares. And then push them down as far as you can reach. You can also use a pencil to push them down further. Now we're going to fold our streamer. So we'll go ahead and take this and fold it in thirds. Roughly, and then roll it. And we want to roll it pretty tight. Again, this is a small body tube, so we need it to be small to get in there. Then we can tuck our shock cord in and then the streamer. And you do want that to be able to come out easily just for safety purposes. So if it's not going in easily, then just re-roll it so it's tighter. Tuck your shock cord in, make sure none of it gets caught between the nose cone and the body tube. You want this nose cone to be a snug fit. If it's too tight, then you can sand it down. If it's too loose, you can actually add some clear tape around here just to make sure it's not gonna fall off, but you do want it to be able to come out with the gases from the engine. Now your rocket is built, so this is a great time to do some painting and finishing if you'd like. If not, you can launch it just like this. But if you are gonna paint it, do some primer first and then sand it between coats to get a nice smooth finish and then paint whatever color you'd like and then you can finish it with your decals. For our final step for preparing for launch, we're gonna put an engine in. And in this rocket, the engine goes in and it's just a friction fit, but you can tell when we put it in here, it's pretty loose. So we're gonna add some masking tape around the engine to make that tighter. So now when we put it in, it's gonna be a nice snug fit and we wanna make sure that's staying in there. So then once you are outside and you're prepared for launch, you can do the very final step, which is putting your igniter in. So you're gonna take your igniter and put it in, making sure that it reaches as far down as you can go without smushing or bending the wires, and then put the plug in to hold it in place. And then if you want to, you can bend these wires just a little bit back to make it easier to attach your clips. And then you're ready to go. Great work building your Wizard rocket, and we hope you have a great time launching. For more detailed guides and resources, visit our website. And if you liked this video, like, subscribe, and hit the bell to be notified of new content. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.